I can hear you say that I'm the one. At times I feel your lips press close to mine, but what good has that dreaming done?
Brooke, it's good to see you. I just wanted to say before I turn the show over to you that these songs are poignant to me and remind me of my teenage years living in Long Island, New York. But the songs being played in this podcast are not actually from the 60s, except for maybe three. I'm going to sound like I'm rambling, because I am. All this will make sense shortly. The people from my generation will know exactly what these songs have in common. The later generations probably won't get it. At least, there are no songs in this show from the 1950s or earlier. They are old for sure, but they're not antique.
Philip, I've got this. You can start playing with your soundboard now. Hello everyone, this is the Antique Music Mall, show number 21. I am your host, Brooke Palmer. Our first song was first released in 1964. 15 years later, the song was resurrected, twice. Louise Goffin barely missed the top 40 in 1979 with this song, peaking at number 43. But 6 months later, still in 1979, Aerosmith came out with a rock version of this song. Aspiring songwriter George Shadow Morton wrote this song. He was recommended by Ellie Greenwich to her husband, Jeff Barry. Mr. Barry wanted to find out if George Morton could give him a song, so he arranged a demo session. However, while driving to Barry's studio for the session, Mr. Morton remembered that he forgot to write a song. So, he pulled over to the side of the road and began writing. Thus, the song was born. And this is that song. Remember, Walking in the Sand. Philip, I will take a Brit for this second song, and let you take that Italian singer, that no one here has ever heard of, for the third song. Tracy Ullman is a multiple award-winning television, stage and film actress, who performs as a comedian, singer, dancer, as well as works as a screenwriter, producer, director, author, and businesswoman. She holds dual British and American citizenship. She emigrated from the United Kingdom to the United States, where she starred in her own network television comedy series, The Tracy Ullman Show, from 1987 until 1990. She later produced programs for HBO, including Tracy Takes On, until 1999. Miss Ullman hit the Billboard Top 100 twice in 1984 with They Don't Know and Breakaway. Both singles also peaked at number 2 and number 4, respectively, in the UK, in 1983. But this is a song from her 1984 album, You Caught Me Out. And the song is Give Him a Great Big Kiss.
When I say I'm in love, you best believe I'm in love, L-U-V.
This third song is the story of a teenage girl who threatens to run away if her mother does not let her do as she pleases. The girl is advised not to leave home by another girl who did the same thing and now regrets it. When the lead girl fell in love with a boy, her mother told her to break up with him because she was too young to be in love. Strangely enough, after she left home, she forgot the boy completely and her mind filled with memories of her caring mother. But it was too late for the girl to return home, because her mother died of a broken heart. Shadow Morton wrote this song and it was first released in October 1965. And a few months later, Giulio Cinquetti released this song in Italian. Signorina Cinquetti is a singer, songwriter, actress, and television presenter. At the age of 16 she won the Sanremo Music Festival in 1964, singing Non Ho L'età, or I'm Not Old Enough. Her win enabled her to represent Italy in the Eurovision Song Contest that year in Copenhagen, singing the same song. And she won her country's first ever victory in the event, becoming the youngest winner of the contest, aged 16 years and 92 days, at that time. Today Giulio Cinquetti is 74 years old.
Senti, questa è la mia storia. Mia madre mi diceva che io ero troppo giovane per piangere per lui. Ma io non l'ho creduta e sono andata via da sola con lui. Poi io l'ho dimenticato e pensavo ogni sera a mia madre, a casa a piangere per me che l'ho lasciata e sono andata via da sola con lui.
E non l'hai vista.
Lasciare mai così come ho fatto io, perché poi quando tornerai non troverai mai più il suo sorriso,
mai.
E non potrai più tornare
mai
ancora a casa da lei.
This next song definitely fits the theme of this podcast, however, we suspect that it will be unfamiliar to most. And the girl group singing this song is obscure. This song is part of only two singles this group released in 1965 and 1966. There are only two versions of this song that were ever recorded and released, as far as we know. Dressed in Black by the Pussycats was released the same month as the original version of this song. The Pussycats were a four-piece girl group working with the Kama Sutra Productions team before their contract was transferred to Columbia Records. You can also find this song on Girls in the Garage, Volume 5, and Where the Girls Are 5, A Decade of Columbia Femme Pop. Is this oldie a lost diamond in the rough? You decide for yourself. We think so.
Thank you.
they just understood that I can't stop loving him because they tell me I should. They tell me over and over that I'm too young to be in love. Well, I don't care what they say, my love just grows stronger with each lonely day. Stairs. I shut the door. I turn the lock. Alone once more. And no one can hear me cry.
After this track, we will tell you what these songs have in common. And this next one is by Agnetha Fältskog, formerly in the group ABBA. And coincidentally, ABBA won the Eurovision contest in 1974, just as Giuliola Cinquetti had done 10 years earlier. That has nothing to do with the theme of this podcast. This song is past, present and future, originally released in 1966, however, this cover version was released nearly 50 years later in 2004. The song isn't even a song, in the sense that there is no singing, that all the lyrics are spoken in a hushed, subdued, almost trance-like state. The music is simply a playing of Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata, a piano melody of calmness and composure, a thing apart from pop music. We know something bad happened to our storyteller in the past, but there is still the future to come. Tomorrow? That's a long way off.
When
present
go out with you, why not? Do I like to dance? Of course. Take a walk along the beach tonight.
At the moment, it
doesn't look good. At the moment, it will never happen again. I don't think it will ever happen again.
If you were around in the 1960s, that should have been a piece of cake for you. If not, I hope you were introduced to some terrific oldies. The Shangri-Las were an American pop girl group formed in 1963 in New York City and disbanded in 1968. They were especially known for their hits Leader of the Pack, Remember Walking in the Sand, and Give Him a Great Big Kiss. The Shangri-Las continued to chart with fairly successful hit records, specializing in adolescent themes such as alienation, loneliness, abandonment, and premature death. The group was formed at Andrew Jackson High School in Cambria Heights, a neighborhood in Queens, New York. There were two sets of sisters in this group. Mary Weiss was the lead singer, and her sister Betty was part of the group. And then you had the twins, Margie and Marianne Gasner. And this podcast will showcase the 12 original songs released by the Shangri-Las and covered by other singers or groups. In this podcast, we will only be playing the covers of songs that were originally released by the Shangri-Las. Of the Shangri-Las' 12 songs that charted, all but three were original songs. You heard Aerosmith's 1980 cover of the Shangri-La No. 5 hit from 1964, Remember Walking in the Sand. And that was followed by Tracy Ullman's 1984 cover of their 1964 Top 20 hit, Give Him a Great Big Kiss. Third, we had You Can Never Go Home Anymore by Giliola Cinquetti. And that was a top 10 hit for the Shangri-Las in 1965. Our fourth song was Dressed in Black, and neither the Shangri-Las or the cover song by the Pussycats charted. And you just heard Agnetha Fältskog of ABBA singing a cover of the Shangri-Las' top 100 hit from 1966, Past, Present, and Future. Full disclosure, this last song might technically be considered a cover of Beethoven's theme Moonlight Sonata. However, the Shangri-Las first released this song with English lyrics, with Artie Butler, Jerry Lieber, and Shadow Morton involved with working on the arrangement and the lyrics. And by the way, Shadow Morton was very involved as a producer and the writer of Shangri-Las songs, but he did not write all the songs presented in this podcast.
On October 10, 1964, Leader of the Pack entered Billboard's Top 100. Moving up the pop chart, this song reached number one during the week of November 28. It remained in the Hot 100 for 12 weeks. This was written by Ellie Greenwich, Jeff Barry, and producer Shadow Morton. Mr. Morton was looking for a follow-up to the first Shangri-La's hit, Remember, Walking in the Sand. He had a motorcycle and was part of a motorcycle gang in his youth. So the three songwriters decided to use that as the theme. Together, they came up with a rather dramatic story, being sure to name the characters in the lyric, Betty and Jimmy, so the listener could form an attachment. A hallmark of the song is the spoken dialogue that sets up the story. Fast forward 21 years. Twisted Sister had a hard rock cover of this song in 1985. It peaked at number 53 on the Hot 100. This song has been covered by a wide range of artists, including Melissa Etheridge, The Chipmunks, and Bette Midler. Runaways lead singer Cherie Curry teamed up with Stooges guitarist James Williamson to release their version in 2019.
We'll be right back. swear it.
Man, it must be great riding with her. We picking her up after school today? By the way, where'd you meet her?
I met her at the candy store. She turned around and saw me and get the picture.
Yeah, we see.
That's what you fell for. Folks were always putting me down.
Down, down.
They said I came from the wrong side of town.
Wrong side of town.
They told her that I was bad, but she knew I was sad. That's why she fell for
the leader of the pack.
Out in the Streets was the Shangri-La's fifth top 100 single. This song hit the top pop singles chart in April 1965, spending 6 weeks there, peaking at number 53. The song was written by Ellie Greenwich and Jeff Barry. It's another teenage alienation song, for which the Shangri-La's are known. The song was covered by Blondie in 1975, but this cover was not released until 1994, when it was included on the Platinum Collection. Blondie subsequently covered it again in 1999 for their album No Exit. Deborah Harry takes lead vocal.
Yeah.
like he did before. He don't wear those dirty old black boots no more.
Bulldog is an original Shangri-La song, first released by the group in February 1965. It was actually the B-side of You Can Never Go Home Anymore. The song did not chart for the Shangri-Las, and only one singer has covered this song, Andy J. Forrest. Between 1985 and 1990, Andy Forrest acted in a dozen films shot in Italy, Morocco, Brazil, Venezuela, and Croatia. Sometimes lead roles. But he never stopped playing. Andy has been playing harmonica and singing professionally since 1977. He has recorded 22 albums and 2 45s. These recordings feature mostly Forrest's original songs. But his Bulldog is a cover. After living in Europe for 10 years, he returned to his home, New Orleans, in 1991, where he plays in clubs and goes on tour in Europe and Canada occasionally. This is Bulldog from Mr. Forrest's 1983 album entitled Hogwild. It was written by Jerry Lieber and Mike Stoller.
How come my bulldog don't bark, baby, when Big Jim comes around? I wanna know. How come my bulldog don't bark, baby, when Big Jim comes around? Doesn't make sense, man. Well, now everybody knows I got the meanest bulldog in town. Well, I can't put a finger on it, but I believe there's something shaking. Well, I can't put my finger on it, but I believe there's something shaking. Mm-hmm.
And if I catch you cheating on me, well, I'm gonna send you back home to me again. Today. Lately I've been dreaming strange dreams about you, baby. Oh, baby, the way you've been acting, you make them all seem so true. Oh, now I've been slaving, blisters on my hands. Something about it all now, baby, I just can't understand. How come my bulldog don't bark, baby, when Big Jim comes around? How come my bulldog don't bow wow, mama, when Big Jim shows his face around? You know, everybody knows I got the meanest bulldog in town. Let me play. Seem true. I've been slaving. I got the blisters on my hands. Something about it. Oh, now, baby, I just can't understand. How come my bulldog don't bite? How come my bulldog don't bow wow? My bulldog. My bulldog don't bite, baby. Baby, and that bulldog don't seem to bark no more. And Big Jim comes around. Yeah. Well, now everybody knows I got the meanest. I got the meanest. I got the meanest bulldog in town.
Shortly before the Shangri-Las went to the United Kingdom for a promotional tour in October 1964, Betty Wise temporarily dropped out, leaving the group as a trio. Many TV clips and photos of the group taken at this time show just Mary Wise and the twins, which led many to recall the group being only a trio. Betty then rejoined the group in mid-1965, and the group appeared as a quartet once again until the start of 1966, when they permanently became a trio again, with Mary Ann and Marge Gassner leaving at different times, replacing each other, until the demise of the group. Next up is an obscure top 100 hit by the ladies. This song is from autumn, 1965. It's called Right Now and Not Later. This song peaked at number 99 and left the pop charts after 2 weeks. This song was covered over 40 years later by The Sirens. If you have never heard of The Sirens, it is because they only released 3 singles and 2 albums, from 2004 through 2007. They are an all-girls garage glam rock band from Detroit, Michigan.
Right now and not
The Shangri-Las initially performed without a name, however, when they signed their first deal, they began calling themselves the Shangri-Las, after a Queens, New York restaurant.
Wait a minute, Brooke. That's interesting. I never heard that before. And did you know that the Four Seasons took their band's name from a New Jersey bowling alley? I think that was our band's problem. We had the wrong name. It certainly couldn't have been our sound. We were terrific.
Philip, what was your band's name?
We were the Dynamantics. You know, the Dynamics plus the Romantics.
That very well could have been your band's downfall. That is a mouthful. If you could go back, what would you call yourself?
That's easy. We should have called ourselves the Hojos. That was the nickname of a very popular restaurant and hotel chain in Long Island back in the 60s.
Too bad. I think you missed your opportunity. That would have been a much simpler name to catch on to. Let me continue the podcast. Philip, you can shut your mic now. Thank you very much. The Shangri-Las only had two LPs amongst a boatload of compilation albums and many 45s over their short 3-year existence. But Mary Wise continued as a solo artist, but never charted on her own. But she never gave up. In 2007, she released two singles and a new album, which is available on both vinyl and as a compact disc. It is called Dangerous Game. And it is off this album that Mary Wise covers Heaven Only Knows, which is the B-side of Give Us Your Blessing. So basically, Mary Wise is covering the Shangri-Las, a group of which she was the lead singer. Only now, it is 48 years after the original version and she is 59 years old. Kudos to her. We suspect that only the most ardent Shangri-Las fans will know their original song, first released by them in July 1964, entitled It's Easier to Cry. It was the B-side of their smash hit, Remember, Walking in the Sand. This song was not written by the usual suspects, but by Joe DeAngelis, J.J. Jackson, and Richard Steinberg. And no one even covered this song until 34 years after its first vinyl pressing. The Detroit Cobras were an American garage rock band from Detroit, Michigan, formed around 1994 by vocalist Rachel Nagy and guitarist Mary Ramirez, with a constantly changing assortment of mostly male sidemen. The Detroit Cobras released their first of five albums in 1998. It was entitled Mink, Rat, or Rabbit. And that is where will we find this rather interesting cover of this Shangri-La's original. Flies when you're having fun. This is the last of the Shangri-La's songs, and it is from 1966. The Vietnam War continues to plague America's efforts to fight communism. But the love of a girl for her soldier is committed and strong. This song peaked at number 33 in the top 100 and remained on Billboard's pop chart for 6 weeks. So let's close the show with the Shangri-La's singing their own song. I hope you enjoyed revisiting the Shangri-Las, or maybe for some, being introduced to them. I am your host, Brooke Palmer. Until next time, cheerio.
We were child but sweet. while you are fighting overseas. And I know one day, if we are lucky, God will send you back to me.
You know you make me wanna shout, keep my heels.